Welcome to the last video in this section about setting up a RIVAGE PM system in preparation for your first event. Last time, we set up the monitor and cue buses and configured the talkback communications. Now, we're going to set up a live recording system, which we can use for virtual sound checks. This will be really helpful during rehearsals and sound checks when the full band, orchestra, choir, or cast are not available. You can play back a recording through some or all of the input channels and still progress through all the scene memories of a show, editing and adjusting as you go, without disturbing the settings of the input patch or mic preamps. To allow this, you need a HY card in the slot 4 of the DSP engine. Or, if you have a PM7 system, slot 3 at the rear of the console. It can be a HY144D or HY144DSRC for Dante, a HY128MD for Maddie, or a WSG-HY128 for Waves Sound Grid. Though, the Dante card will provide the most channels, up to 144. When a card is installed in the last HY slot, or a virtual card is selected in the system config, then a special patch grid will appear in the recording tab of the patch window. Here you see all input channels listed vertically on the left, and there are two grids. The grid on the right is for rec out, while the grid in the center is for playback in. Let's talk about rec out first. This patch is separate from the direct out, which can be set from several different positions in the signal chain. This rec out is fixed at the pre-digital gain position. Look at an input channel's signal flow, and you can see that this is before the channel processing. So you are recording the signal as it's coming into the DSP engine from the I/O units. Back to the recording patch, and you can select which channels you wish to record onto your multi-track machine or computer. Use the continuous patch button for a one-to-one patch, or do it manually. As you do, notice the playback in patch gets set to match the rec out patch. That makes sense if you want to play the audio back through the same channels later. Otherwise, hold shift while you patch to keep the grids independent. Once you've made your patch, store it into the scene memory, or global paste the patch for the inputs to multiple scenes if you wish to use the virtual sound check with a range of scene memories. For example, to simulate a complete set of songs with the recording. Now that is set, let's talk about how to record using Dante. Remember, there is an additional Dante patch to take care of. If you mount the device in the system config for the HY slot, then you can set the Dante patch on the console. Otherwise, you could use Dante controller software running on the same computer as your recording software. Note that the maximum number of channels that can be recorded using Dante Virtual Sound Card is 64, and that's at 48 kHz. So 32 channels at 96K. Therefore, if you run the RIVAGE PM system at 96K, you may want to use a sample rate converter card to run the recording at 48K. Alternatively, you can use a Dante PCIe card like Yamaha's Dante Accelerator AIC128D. This can handle up to 128 channels in and out, even at 96 kHz. If you need more than 128 channels, you'll need two computers. In that case, you should use Cubase or Nuendo software and enable the system link function, which keeps them in sync. Remember, it's best to record onto a separate hard drive from the operating system and make sure it has a fast write speed. A USB-C solid-state drive would be ideal. And you'll need about 1 gigabyte of space per hour for each channel. Once you've made a recording, let me show you how to use it for a virtual sound check. First, in this column of ticks, select which channels you want to play back. For example, you won't want to play back any internal effects returns. So, uncheck them. And you might not want to play back all instrument and vocal channels. Perhaps some performers are ready to sound check live along with the recording. So you simply uncheck their channels. By the way, using Dante, it's easy to run a virtual sound check through multiple consoles. Just connect each DSP HY slot 4 or Rivage PM7 slot 3 to the same Dante network and multicast transmit the computer outputs to each console. It'll probably need to be multicast because of the flow limitations of the computer's sound card. Then switch on the virtual sound check using the button in the recording patch window and confirm. Now, the inputs from the stage to the selected channels will be silenced, and you'll hear the multi-track recording playback through those channels instead. Recall any scene you like and adjust the settings as normal. If you store or update a scene, it will keep the existing preamp settings, so the virtual sound check operation does not get in the way of your programming. It's really helpful for fine-tuning your channel processing and effects without needing the performers to repeat their parts over and over again. Notice you have the yellow VSC indicator flashing in the status box. Always keep a lookout for that, because at some point you're going to have a tea break, and when you return, you'll forget about the virtual sound check and wonder why no sound is coming to you from the stage. You can also see the VSC indicators in the input channel name displays at the bottom of the screen. Quickly disable the VSC to get back to normal operation. And that's all. Now you're ready to start manipulating and mixing the sound, setting the gains, filters, EQ, dynamics, plugins, and mix routing. That's a whole new world of fun, and you can expect a new series of videos in the future to talk you through all the possibilities. Also, look out for a video about using Nuendo Live multi-track recording software with Rivage PM systems. From version 5, the console can remote control the transport, transfer channel names and colors, and write markers with each scene recall. But for now, thanks for going on this journey with me, setting up Rivage PM systems. We've managed the system configuration, input and output patching, channel names, user preferences, custom fader layers, home keys, view keys, bookmarks, monitor, and talkback. Maybe it seems like a lot of work, but it's going to make the process of mixing a show so much more efficient and enjoyable. You should be able to focus purely on the sound rather than searching for some forgotten little feature. Thanks for watching. Take care until next time.